a Washington way of behaving.
And I want you to take a listen to this comment from Wilbur Ross today, talking about his experience in Saudi Arabia, which apparently went very well as far as the Secretary of Commerce is concerned.
The other thing that was fascinating to me, there was not a single hint of a protester anywhere there during the whole time we were there. Not one guy with a bad placard.
Of course, there's a reason why there weren't protesters in the streets of Saudi Arabia. Would you like to enlighten our audience?
Did no one tell him that, like, either they're already in jail or they would be if they got anywhere near him?
Right. I mean, or dead.
Or
they've
yeah.
been...
Right. There's no placards. Yeah. There's no placards.
Exactly. It's one of the rules.
Right. But, you know, Wilbur Ross is a smart guy. Where would
his
statement...
Look, he probably misspoke. Look, this trip's been a huge success, both on symbolism... as well as substance. I mean, I think, you know, across the TV dials, whether it's this network or others, I've seen nothing but favorable reviews from the president's trip in terms of the terrorism financing center that was established in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, which is unprecedented.
To cut down on, to eliminate.
To eliminate, yeah. You know, to work cooperatively in a collaborative fashion on eliminating financing, headquartered in the country that houses two of the most holiest sites in Islam, a big victory for the president, a huge arms deal, you know, deployed THAAD to Saudi Arabia. The Saudis are paying for it themselves. We're not paying for it. So burden sharing, you know, economic development. It's a big victory. I think the bad part for the president is just to come home next week.
Jeff, what do you think? You're a Middle East expert.
I would dissent slightly from that view and make the case that the president picking one of the most repressive countries on earth to make his first visit to might be not the correct signal that a U.S. president, leader of the world's leading liberal democracy, wants
where
to
would
stand.
You have suggested he go if he was going to go to a Muslim or an Arab country? Would you suggest Jordan?
Where
would you...
I would have suggested Canada and Mexico first. I'm just a traditionalist in that regard, and then I would have said there's a whole host of allies that one could visit across the planet that deserve American recognition, from Europe to Asia. But yeah, I would say Saudi Arabia, obviously Israel, obviously deserve to be visited, but I don't think it's the right timing, and I don't think that the symbolism is what we want to, and you know, I mean, Saudi Arabia not only is one of the most repressive countries in the world, it is the source of obviously some counterterrorism, but it's also the source of terrorism. I mean, it's sort of the complete package, and that was elided, let's say. That was not talked about during this visit, that Saudi Arabia is the source of a great deal of financing for terrorism and actual terrorists, including the 9/11 terrorists.
15 of the 19, and I will say.